little backstage from Scott Moyer. As our last couple takes the ice, Hubble and Donahue.
Number 10, representing USA, Madison Hubble and Zachary Donahue.
They were third at Skate Canada in their only other Grand Prix assignment. Now hoping to hold on to second here in order to qualify for what would be their third straight trip to the Grand Prix final. Very fast twizzles opening this program. You can see that they're very in control with every movement. The only Americans at this event, and Hubble and Donahue do have a pretty firm hold on one of the three spots that the U.S. has for ice dance at the upcoming Olympic Games in Pyeongchang. It looks totally effortless, and all of a sudden they're flying across the ice. Well-skated program here. Certainly the strongest they've skated this free dance to date. The way that they weave their technical elements with the music and with their connecting steps,
again, effortless is just a word that keeps coming to mind. They make it look so easy, incredibly talented.
Madison Havel, Jack Reed の冬組の演技でした。
Well, they started the season with a victory at the U.S. International Figure Skating Classic in Salt Lake City, and then went on to that bronze medal at Skate Canada. And in the process of finishing on the podium there, they produced the second best free dance performance, right behind Virtue and Moyer, who won in Canada. And starting this free dance second behind that same couple of Virtue and Moyer.
And I think this is an interesting program choice for anyone. In fact, I don't think almost any other team would manage to make this program look good. The way that they take command of the music is fantastic. If there's something that I'd like to see, it's just I want to see them get in each other's faces just a little bit more. I think they could just be a little bit more raw. Everything looks so polished, so clean. You know, it's funny to say that you want it to look less clean, but with a performance like this, as you could see in the beginning, just the raw emotion, that look, we needed more of that throughout the rest of the performance. I think they got away from that feeling a little bit. Just if they want to really maximize their score, I think their greatest strength is their ability to play off of each other. And when they are face to face, you can feel it in the rink like no other team can create. It's really impressive. But again, that doesn't take it away at all from their skating ability. It's really incredible. They're so strong, so powerful. They really create an atmosphere when they're skating their programs.
Now second behind Virtue and Moyer at the start of the night. They also trained with Virtue and Moyer in Montreal. They made that move not too long ago. Packed up the car, drove north, figured they had to get away from other U.S. couples, U.S. competition. They wanted to raise their game by being around others at the highest level of the sport.
And they absolutely have raised their game. The last two seasons, they've improved and progressed an amount that I didn't even know they could. And it just goes to show what the proper motivation, the proper coaching can do for a team. They have really, I mean, they were, you know, they were a Twizzle sequence away from winning a world bronze medal last year. They are contenders. And if they can continue to skate consistently and just keep improving Both programs, I think, have room for improvement. But if they can continue to go back and see where it can get better, they absolutely have a shot of going to the Olympics with a chance for a medal.
Happy birthday, Diddy.
Virtue and Moyer backstage. Lenote and Capellini.
The scores, please.
And now Hubble and Donahue.
Havel, Donohue's total score, 112.04. Total score, 118.35.
A nod of acknowledgement. And they end the ice dance competition the way they started the free dance in second place. And that should be enough to qualify them for their third consecutive trip to the Grand Prix final in early December back in Japan.